I used to be a huge supporter of Blackberry, but then I always find myself rooting for the underdog. It's no surprise then that I stayed loyal to this mobile platform and operating system for several years, I believe shy of 5 years to be more specific. It's strange how I didn't see the light when considering the all-conquering Swiss Army knife touchscreen bar smartphone like these ones. I used to think buttons could never be replaced, and I still see a bit of that reasoning in my mindset, backwards and ignorant as it might seem. But let's get back to the BlackBerry and to the Curve, more specific, that I have in front of me. Actually, I have two of them, one original black and this one slightly modified. This was my original phone. I bought it new, and during the course of my usage, I replaced the keyboard, the screen protection, the screen glass, and this piece of trim here. I replaced them with some vibrant red trim pieces, OM pieces, so I kind of like this color combination. But anyway, RIM or BlackBerry became popular in the late 1990s and early 2000s and have cemented their mantra by offering good quality products with excellent software support and highly sought after data protection. Sure, early designs look like oversized pagers, but there is some beauty when you start to realize that form follows function here, and once you use a BlackBerry for long enough, you cannot think of a smartphone or any other cell phone for that matter without these classic proportions. You even start to consider them beautiful. It's like the Porsche 911. You think that putting an engine in the back of the car might seem cumbersome and counterintuitive, yet 70 years on or so, they're still at it, more popular than ever. But there I go again with bombastic car comparisons. I just find the BlackBerry sort of similar. So anyway, the 8520 model, or the 8520, is a low mid-ranger phone, all plastic, no frills. But with the exquisite keyboard ergonomics we've come to expect from RIM. At least that's how a review would have started in 2009 when this phone was launched. A lot of glossy plastic, not such great quality feel, but excellent resistance and reliability. You could drop it, throw it. The 8520 knows how to take a punch. This particular unit was even chewed by my dog, and well, you can sort of see some results here because actually, the plastic seems to have cracked. A bit disappointing that this chassis, the back plate of the phone, is rubberized. It's that multi-component paint system which sort of degrades over time. It was supposed to be self-healing, but now it's just rubbing off on my fingers. So it's kind of gross and yeah, it's not pleasant at all. It takes quite a bit of time to turn on, but battery life is excellent. So without any further ado, let's try to turn this little beast on. Okay, so far I tried charging it up via USB cable from the PC, but now I got a break, and I'll try to connect it. See if this will work. I don't know, the battery seems to be dead in both of them, so that would be quite a shame, wouldn't it? If I went all this way and wouldn't be able to show the phone to you. Okay, there we go. Anyway, we'll wait for a few seconds and hopefully this thing will turn on its own accord. These two phones actually were used sort of extensively, and This one was mine, and this one was my wife's. So yeah, we just threw them in junk cupboards, so we just keep them as mementos. But being sloppy, I guess I failed to charge them regularly, so I left the battery to drain for about 2, maybe actually 5 years. So imagine if the batteries, these both of these batteries, stay drained for about 5 years. Yeah, there's some chance they're not going to recover. It took quite some time to turn on, but the battery life was excellent when it worked. When looking at this model, I do miss the scroll ball from the previous generation 8320 Curve, that this touch sensitive button is more efficient and I suspect cheaper to make than the pocket lint magnet pearl ball scroll. Typing is a delight though. I still miss the exquisite tactile feel and click of this device. It was truly a good enough reason to type with both your hands on this device. Browsing the web on this thing is a no-go. Sure, you could do it, but so could you ride a horse to work, and even if that sounds fun, it's not necessarily quick and reliable, so you still take your car or public transportation. Same here with the BlackBerry and touchscreen smartphones comparison. And also, you could pretend to be a snob all you like, but the truth is that mostly businessmen and businesswomen use these things at the height of their popularity, and let's be honest, not many of us are businessmen or businesswomen. Me, I like it for its no-frills, sensible, practical approach towards basic communication needs. Kinda wish I still had an option when it comes to hard keys on smartphones. Yeah, I know there are some startups out there that offer similar QWERTY factors, but this design has been so neglected that those companies need to charge an arm and a leg on their phone just to keep relevant. So the R&D cost is astronomical. Plus, the devices are not so competitive, so you end up spending extra for the nostalgia-induced gimmick and not for a competitive product. But listen to me prattling on. It seems that the BlackBerry has turned on. So as you can see, I'm rambling here and it still hasn't booted up. And this thing is typical of all BlackBerry models. So yeah, this one is in a better aesthetic condition than my personal one that I used. Yeah, the rigidity of the phone is okay. It's a device on par with lower offerings from the time. Feel is not that great, except for the keyboard, which is absolutely a delight. It's simply the best feeling keyboard on a phone ever. And that's my opinion. That's my thought on it. Okay, let's see what's happening here. There's a nice cat on the screensaver here. So anyway, I've forgotten how to operate this thing. I do like the display. It's an LCD unit, but actually it's surprisingly crisp. I wasn't expecting this level of I don't know what you call it, muscle memory, or maybe instant familiarity with this device, but actually I love the design of the icons. I especially adore the lack of animation. I can't really stand that on modern smartphones, you know, the swiveling screens and multiple widgets and tile designs and so on, and things that move around in 3D fashion. That's just not for me. Okay, let's confirm the hour just for the sake of moving forward and go to the settings. The font is a bit is bolded. I don't particularly like that, but still, let's try to type something. Okay, you see, muscle memory and usage. I thought this was a touch screen. No, it's not. Okay, let's try to type something. Okay, again, muscle memory. I instantly feel the urge to touch the screen. Okay. So I am going to type whatever I speak. Okay, so I might have been overly optimistic about my typing abilities here. I do have sausage fingers, and really, these keyboards are small, they're minuscule. But still, 6 years on or 7 years on since I abandoned this type of phone, and I'm still able to intuitively click and to, not only to press the buttons themselves, but to familiarize myself with the force necessary, the input that I need to give to the phone in order to, in order to type, basically. Yeah, that's an overly complicated way of saying that I know this phone and I miss the keyboards. Oh, look, so the camera, I believe it's a 5-megapixel unit. Of course, it's nothing spectacular. I don't know if you can see the screen right now. So, no, this is not a performance-oriented camera. At any rate, this has been my honest, no-frills, but nostalgic review of the BlackBerry 8520 Curve, the entry-level entry model, but also a sort of a throwback to the RIM platform and what it did offer. In my opinion, I thought and I still think that the last true classic BlackBerry is the 9900 build. I kind of wished I had owned that, but actually they were quite expensive by the time they were launched, and well, I had already switched to Android. Even if I'm rooting for the underdog, I'm still a practical, sensible person, so I decided to save up some money and go mainstream with a more accessible device. Also, along the years, I thought to myself I should buy the Priv model, you know, the slider keyboard full Android device, but that also was obscenely expensive at launch, and over the years, as it became irrelevant, it still was expensive to own new, and I didn't want to own it secondhand, so I sort of skipped that phase altogether. So, anyway, nice memories, nice devices, life goes on, and so on and so forth. Thank you for watching, and see you in my next installment.